Greetings, friends. David Marks here. Organizing your photography with Adobe Photoshop Lightroom Classic is not intuitive. Now, I've been recording videos for years where I take a deep dive into one specific tool. I have long videos on Classic's keywording panel and every other feature of the library module. But today, I want to offer you an overview, a high-level discussion of the three pillars of optimal image organization without getting bogged down in any of the little details. If you're ready to learn some essential concepts, then let's jump right in and let's get started. The first question that we all need to answer when we begin to organize our digital photography is, where should all of my digital images live? Part of the answer here is obvious. Anything that you want Lightroom Classic to track must be stored inside of some folder on one of your hard drives. As an analogy, think of your hard drive as if it were a big house with a series of separate rooms. Each room contains a different type of file or application. Your music, for example, belongs in the music room. Your documents belong in the documents room. Only in computer vocabulary, we don't call them room. We call these divisions folders. Your photography is no different. If we zoom in a little further, then we have to ask ourselves, well, how am I going to keep things neat and tidy within my pictures folder? The answer here is chronology. The correct way to organize your photo storage folders is by the date of image capture. Now, this may not be the way that you think you want to organize your folders, but trust me, this is the way. I promise that we will get to organizing by words for the names and places, words for things that you will remember in just a minute. But when it comes to our folder structure, chronology is the way to go. If I jump back into Lightroom Classic right now, and if I open up the folders panel here in the library module, then you can see that what I have in this part of Classic is an exact match with the folder structure that you saw a moment ago at the operating system level. This might be obvious, but a folder structure built with capture dates makes it easy to find images from a particularly memorable day, like the 4th of July or Christmas. In addition, if you look closely at the name of my photographs, then you will see that there is a direct correlation between my file names and my folder names. But I can hear you screaming that searching for files or folders by date has its limits. And that brings us to our next mechanism of image organization. When I want to find images of a person, of a place, or of a thing, then it's time to turn to our metadata search tools. If I want pictures of my dog, for example, then I can activate one of Classic's metadata search features and type in her name. I can do something similar if I want to see all of my top-rated landscape photos or landscapes from the United States only. Metadata is image-specific, which is why Lightroom can quickly and easily sort out all of my 5-star images from the ones that don't have that rating, no matter where those images live. With metadata, there are no physical limits on the amount of searchable information that you can add into any one image. To be clear, there's a practical limit. There's no benefit from adding keywords or search terms that you're never going to use and remember. But unlike with folders, an image can carry as many keywords as you want, and you can modify that image's metadata again and again as time goes on. The third mechanism that Classic offers us are collections. With collections, we can gather together a bunch of images, even if those photographs do not live inside of the same folder or share any common metadata. If you want to pull together a portfolio of your 10 best photographs, for example, then a collection is the simplest way to complete this kind of project. I need to make it really clear that when you associate an image with a project, you are not moving that file from one folder to another around your hard drive. This is a vital distinction, and it's one that an awful lot of Classic users do not fully understand. Because collections are not hard drive folders, any image can be a member of more than one collection at the same time. If I create a second collection, let's say one for my favorite sunset images, then I can add in some of the photos that are already in the portfolio collection, but I can also associate other photos with this project too. Collection membership can be an A and a B and a C, unlike with folders, where an image can only exist in folder A or in folder B, but the same file cannot be in both places at the same time. Finally, collections are visible in all of Lightroom Classic's other modules. So if you want to work with the slideshow, the book, or the print module, then collections are a tool that you'll eventually need to master. To recap, if you use each of these tools properly, then image organization with Lightroom Classic is fast and efficient. But let me warn you that there's a lot of bad advice out there. There's also a lot more to learn here. In this lecture, I've skipped over all of the technical details. Those details are important. So if these organizational concepts make sense for you now, then I encourage you to dig deeper so that you can get the most out of your time with Lightroom Classic.
I hope that you found this video helpful. If you learned something today, then please hit the subscribe button and leave us a like or a comment down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next tutorial.